A genome is the listing of all the genes present in a species. It's just all the genetic information that encompasses that species. I'm Jim Musser. I'm the chair of the Department of Pathology and Genomic Medicine at Houston Methodist Hospital. So genome mapping is the process that we go through to sequence the entire genome of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, or for that matter, any microbial pathogen. In the case of SARS-CoV-2, it's 30,000 base pairs, or you can think of it as 30,000 letters that we go through. So you can think of mutations as being analogous or similar to a typographical error in a sentence. And that's all that it is. It's a mutation is simply you've changed the letter from the correct one to a different one. Think of the genome as the sentence of the microbe. The more sentences or the more pathogens that are out there, the more variants we're going to get. Here with the almost 30,000 SARS-CoV-2 genomes that we've sequenced, we've learned a variety of different things. One is that we now, here in Houston, in the metropolitan area, we now have all of the major variants of concern or variants of interest that have been described by the CDC and the World Health Organization. One of the common ones that you've probably heard about is the so-called UK, the United Kingdom variant called B117. Based on our extensive genome mapping and our ability to mate the genome sequences with the patient information, which is a very powerful thing to do, we can mate that up and ask very important questions about disease severity and other things that are important from a clinical standpoint. We have learned that this United Kingdom B117 variant, it does have an increased ability, slightly increased ability, to cause a patient to go into the hospital. And that's identical to what's been described by the United Kingdom, and most recently, actually in Norway. We need to understand which variants are here in Houston, Texas, and we need to use that information to encourage everyone to do things like we're all doing on a day in, day out basis, which is to mask up, socially distance, don't aggregate indoors in large groups, and so forth. Vaccination is the way out of this problem, even if we've got additional variants that are coming on board.